Hey guys, so excited to have you on with me today. Just sitting here in the parking lot outside of my workout, I was thinking, gosh, I never do any workout videos. You guys don't even know what my workouts look like, but we use the Power Plate at Swiss Fit here in Bozeman. Incredible workout and really good for anti-aging and improving everything. Anyway, I'm inspired because we just had our paychecks at 11 o'clock Mountain Time. We got the email. Hey there, Michelle. And I don't know about you, but it was such an incredible paycheck today that I know I've already been receiving texts and messages about how mind-blowing this business is and how generous our company is. And I was thinking, as I was sitting here, I was thinking to myself, you know, what an incredible opportunity for all of us to receive such an incredible paycheck today. I don't know if you know this, but today is what is known as Giving Tuesday. Facebook is matching donations when you pick one of the nonprofits to give to. And I'm going to share a couple of the nonprofits I'm passionate about because, hello, these paychecks were huge. And we're paying it forward. So I want to encourage each of you to pay it forward today. I even have on my blessed t-shirt under my big snowball type cardigan. Blessed. So what nonprofits do we have our eye on? Well, one is called the Night Night Project. And this is a nonprofit based out of San Francisco. And 1 in 30 children will be homeless in the United States in the next 12 months. So what this nonprofit's goal is to provide each and every child across the U.S. when they leave the shelter to have their own night-night bag, and in it is a book to encourage reading and family bonding, a cozy blankie, and a little stuffed toy to hug and become a dear friend to them. So that touches my heart. I don't know about you guys. I want to see, what are you passionate about giving to? Because I want to encourage you all, whether you are a thriver or not, we have so very much that we take for granted in this life. Let's pay it forward today. Giving Tuesday is today. Facebook is matching that. So don't be shy today about supporting these nonprofits. And I'm going to share a couple with you. Like I said, you can find your own. You can share them here in this video. I would absolutely love to see what everyone is supporting. Another one that comes to mind for me is called the ICRA Fund. My friend here in Bozeman and her friend also started this nonprofit. What it does is it educates girls in the most remote regions of Pakistan, in the valleys where the Taliban has a stronghold. And they saw an opportunity to support local people in building schools and educating girls and boys, but particularly girls, because girls in that area are not counted even in the census. And this group, they build schools. $5,000 builds a school. $5,000. Can you imagine? It houses all of those children. It educates them. It provides for the salary. Just $5,000. Oh my gosh, you all. That's it. Think about it. If 100 of us contributed $50, we built a school. Last year, all of us built 5 schools there. Okay, so I'm going to encourage you all to support them. I'll drop that in the comments below. All of the money goes to supporting the local schools and the volunteers who are local to the area and know all of the social mores and cultural norms, and they get it done. Okay, so I'm going to post that below. Another one that I absolutely love is called Pardada Pardi. And are you guys even able to hear me today? Can anyone comment? I don't see your comments. Facebook is being so weird. I wish Facebook was all over it with this video because I hope to inspire some people. But another one is called Pardada Pardi, and this one is based out of India. And again, locally led by volunteers, founded by an Indian man. And this school also educates girls. When the families send the girls to the school, did you know that in India, the girls aren't counted in the census either? They don't have toilets, right? So think about that, women. Think about that. Your monthly, guess what? Those poor girls, they don't even have showers to clean. I mean, come on, they don't even have the personal care products.
And the families receive money when they marry the children. And they marry them as children, right? 14 years old. Think about that. My son is 14. Can I imagine sending him to a new family? No, I cannot. But families there are so desperately poor that they receive a dowry when they marry the girls out. So the school supports the family by putting money into their savings account when they commit to the girls going to the school. And the school provides them with the clothing, with the medical care, with the personal care. Because most girls quit going to school at 12 worldwide because they do not have feminine care products. Think about that. We take that so much for granted. Ah, it blows my mind. So today, Giving Tuesday, choose a charity that you can contribute to. Give big. You are so blessed in so many ways. Here in Laval, we received incredibly big paychecks today, and we are paying it forward. So I'm asking, how will you pay it forward today? Type your favorite nonprofit, please, in the comments below. I'm going through some of my favorites that we contribute to regularly. Another one I love is Charity Water. 100% of their proceeds also go to the volunteers who locally provide water to people around the world. I am part of what is called the Spring. And what that means is those are the people that are contributing every single month to Charity Water, to help to provide clean water for people around the world. Since Charity Water became a nonprofit, since they were founded, they have now provided clean water. Think about it. Clean water. Not just giving them a bottle of water, which then contributes to more trash, but literally a clean well to over 7 million people. Incredible. Another one that I absolutely love is called Nourish. And our company does this. So I have my Nourish on AutoShip. Who also AutoShips Nourish? What this program is partnered with Rise Against Hunger. You can Google them, a nonprofit, again, run by volunteers locally on the ground, which has the biggest impact, you all, in the poorest areas of the world when the local people get on board to help this initiative and support their communities. So what Thrive Against Hunger does, the nonprofit parent company is called Rise Against Hunger, and our campaign is called Thrive Against Hunger, and we have a product called Nourish, and that goes directly to the people. Directly to the people. So, hey, you guys, hey, Carol, we're talking about the incredible paychecks we received today and paying it forward in a big way. Today is Giving Tuesday. I'm going through some of my favorite nonprofits that I support. Locally here, what we support is called Heroes and Horses. And this is a program where they take the PTSD vets. It was founded by Micah Fink back in 2014. In fact, Yeti made a 7-minute documentary movie on them. And, this group is supported by Justin Timberlake and all kinds of incredible people that are well known, and as well as the local people here in Bozeman, Montana. And what we do is provide experiences to the vets that come back, and they get training on how to work with horses. They get to experience hardship up in the mountains, because who's been in the mountains? I'm telling you, you go back there for a month, you're going to be challenged. I used to teach Outward Bound, and we'd take kids into the backcountry for a month at a time. I even survived a grizzly bear charge and being tracked by mountain lions twice. It's hardship in the backcountry, right? And I think that's part of what gave me such an unstoppable mindset, is because I have faced and overcome incredible challenges in my life, right? In so many different ways. And I have received help from people who had been incredibly blessed financially, like I am now. And that is why I give big, and pay it forward so much. That's why I do random acts of kindness. That's why I tip the bill. You know what? I think that money is energy. I don't have this scarcity attitude of I gotta grip it tightly and hold on to it, and I'm worried it'll never come back into my life. Even when I was down to negative balance in the bank, even when I was on food stamps, I was scraping up some coins in the back seat to give to those who were not as well off as I was. Because let's be honest, even when I've had a negative bank account balance, things have been really good, even then, right? But it's also my attitude. I've always chosen to see things as a springboard into what's next, right? A chapter of preparation. So, like I said in the video title, I am inspired. I'm literally just talking about whatever comes to mind. But I hope that you all experience such incredible blessings. You were designed for incredible financial abundance. You were designed to give big in this world and create impact. And when we do that together, even if you contribute $5 towards a cause, you create impact. Because if everyone donates the $5, incredible impact. Teresa, tell us about Fisher House Foundation. Type it up in the comments for us. Anyone else watching this video, if you're live, you're watching the replay, type replay. But if you're live or watching the replay, I want you to type in the comments a nonprofit that you are going to pay it forward to today. Today is Giving Tuesday. Facebook is matching donations. Please, please, please do it. You went shopping this weekend on the big sales. Pay it forward. I was like, how blessed are we? I got to buy some of the most incredible discounted electronics, and I bought some new bedding for the kids' beds. And like, I was thinking to myself, how incredibly blessed are we? And then we get this incredible paycheck today, mind-blowing paycheck, like tear-jerking paycheck. So many people, so blessed. The messages I've received are so incredible. You all, pay it forward. Pay it forward in faith, knowing that more will come back to you. The blessings will rain down. The more giving that you are, the more you receive. And notice, when you my hand like this, so I like to think of money as when my hand is open, I am open to giving and receiving, and the money just flows easily. If I am going into a scarcity mindset and I'm comparing myself to other people and I'm comparing my whatever, if you ever go into comparison, your hand will go like this and the money will not flow. It will not come to you easily. And when you are blocking the money from flowing to you, how can you give big? Do you see? So we have to allow. We have to live in faith. We have to be open to receive, to use our gifts, to leave our comfort zone. The most dangerous place to be is in your comfort zone. And yes, we all are there because we have vehicles to drive. We have a pantry full of food. We have a closet full of clothes that we don't even wear. Like, hello, if you can't give financially, go through the closet and the things and donate it to the Salvation Army today. Provides, give back in some way, whatever way you are capable of. And I'll tell you what, the blessings rain down when you don't hold on to things with a scarcity mindset really tightly. And you just open up your hands and you are like open and you just say, you know what, I'm here, I want to give, I'm open to receive. And the blessings rain down. Okay, it is such a cool thing that happens. I really wish I had my tripod today because my phone is so shaky. I'm so fired up. I'm like really talking with my hands. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and have now committed to making a plan to give big in the world, because I'll tell you what, you live your life in that abundance mindset and just know that you know that you are taken care of. Because I'll tell you what, if you look at the plants right now, I'm looking around, everything looks dead, all of our plants and trees, because they're dormant, right? But come spring, magically, they start growing again. They start blooming again. What is that magical force behind life? Think about it. It's within each and every single one of us. We have access to that knowingness all the time. All the time. Every day. Anyway. It's time for my workout. I gotta run. I love you all. Thanks for tuning in today. And give big, live your life in faith, and leave that comfort zone behind, because nothing good happens there. It's stagnant. It gets dark and ick, and people feel ew. But when you live in your outside of your comfort zone and you're serving others and helping others, that's where you find growth and love and peace and joy and abundance and all the good things that you want. Just keep taking that leap of faith. All right. Love you guys. See you soon. See you in Seattle, right? Who's going to Seattle? Who's going to North Carolina in January? Type it in the comments. Okay, bye.